on somebody for the script, hey, just do it. Y'all got to rename it, you said?
No, I said they would come.
What's
funny is, like, 3 days before that happened, literally, that's what they
were
like.
Yeah.
We asked about
it. He's
like, oh, it's all
Rod.
Yeah.
I said that for real.
Like, 100%. Yeah. But you know the crazy thing is, like, it's actually probably, like, good publicity because, like, a lot of people probably had never even watched it.
Yeah.
So that's like, let me go see what this is.
He got tweeted and talked about it.
Can you imagine like LeBron and like Nick squaring off?
Testing, testing, testing. 1, 2, 3.
Dude, after they beat the Warriors, we didn't slide them around that whole next football season.
Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3. Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3. Testing, testing, testing. Testing, testing. Bro, you have I said in my opinion.
Oh,
all right.
Yes. I'm trying to test this microphone.
Testing, 1, 2, 3.
You gotta get all the way through and be
nah,
current.
Get all the way through. Get at least 5 episodes in. I don't have no class on Thursday, dude.
No, yeah, I'm only 30 minutes.
It's only 30 minutes?
Well,
I definitely can't get this shit.
I think it's like, I think it's actually 40. I don't know how long the ad's up, but just get runtime for it. Can you guys hear me? Testing. 1, 2, 3. Testing. 1, 2, 3. Comment if you can hear me. Testing, 1, 2, 3.
He did not even talk to me like that. Right?
Testing, 1, 2, 3.
We kept repeating himself too.
For real, like he was saying the same thing.
Testing, 1, 2, 3.
Because they were talking about how many 110 they ran.
Oh, yeah, because he would have been
yeah. He said, hell no, I'm at South Alabama.
I was dying.
Yeah, he said, like, Ruben and somebody else had, like, stopped him.
Yeah, because Eddie was like, yeah, we had some walk ons about to lead the team. And then Ryan was like, scholarship too. Mine was gone.
Well,
not
Jack.
I mean, that's me.
You're not going to the right
part, Jack. Gotta have that mind, right?
out that weekend.
So short, bro. God, tight.
Just like they ask about LeBron, just say you respect them.
Say, you know, legal matters. It's a legal matter. That's probably what it's going to be. It's like, this is a legal matter. We're not, I can't speak on it.
Guys, coach, all up with a statement. Raise your hand, keep him up for a second.
How's everybody? I hope everybody had an enjoyable holiday. You know, we're kind of looking for, you know, the people on this team that has got the conviction and commitment to sort of the principles and values that we've established and the standard that we've established around here in terms of the toughness we want to play to, the effort we want to give, the discipline to execute that we need to have. And I think we got a little more knowledge and experience and leadership on offense, and I think we're making progress defensively. We're looking for players who can play to this standard. And we're talking about intangibles here now. We're not talking about ability. We're talking about guys that will give effort, play with toughness, finish plays, mental and physical toughness when things get difficult, and have the discipline to go out there and execute and do their job and be responsible enough to know what they're supposed to do, how they're supposed to do it, why it's important to do it that way. And if they don't know, you know, come and see their coach so we got a chance to teach them. So, you know, we got to get some people that have some conviction to what we're trying to accomplish around here. You know, we started today a little bit on next year's opponents, which is something that we'll continue to do, you know, throughout the remainder of the spring, especially in things that we have not seen, which obviously for the inexperienced players make it a little bit more difficult, because you got two things happening. You got install for what we're learning for the first time around, and then we're making adjustments to things that we haven't seen before. In the scrimmage this week, always in the first scrimmage to me, it's always interesting to let the players play, see who can go out there and execute and who will compete and run and hit and play on both sides of the ball, play with toughness. And when the coaches leave the field and don't tell them what to do, who can be responsible enough to go out there and know what to do, make the calls and do the things that we need to do to get the execution that we need. You know, so that'll be the goal. We don't have a plan yet for what quarterback's taking what snaps. Tua was able to practice some today, was able to throw the ball a little bit, so he's getting back into it. We had him on a pitch count. We didn't really do a lot with him, but he was able to do a lot of things in practice today, so that's encouraging. I don't know if he'll be ready to go on Saturday or not. Raekwon Davis was out of practice today with a twisted ankle that he got goofing around off the field. Trayvon Diggs hurt his ankle Thursday in practice, and he was out for today. Don't have a timetable for when these guys will get back. Jerry Jeudy hurt his knee, not on the field, off the field, and needed to get a scope. So he got scoped, and we don't have a timetable for when he'll return, but it's not a serious injury. So those three guys were guys that were out of practice. So we have quite a few players out of practice, which is an opportunity for some younger guys to get more reps and have more experience, get more experience. But you know, it's also challenging for us as coaches to be able to bring these guys along so they can play with confidence.
Start on the back left with Reiner.
Considering that the last two defensive coordinators had a secondary background. What excited you about Tosh, and what gave you the confidence that he was ready to call the plays on defense?
Well, you know, Tosh is a hard worker. He works really, really hard at learning our defense, learning our scheme. And there's two things that you have to be able to do. You have to learn the scheme and know the scheme, but you also have to know how to apply it, which is what makes for a good signal caller when the game comes. And, you know, Tosh has never coached the secondary. That doesn't mean he doesn't understand it or doesn't know it. And we are all trying to do as much as we can to help him. And I think he does understand the concepts of what he needs to know to be able to implement the defense. And, you know, I think Pete has been a coordinator before, which certainly helps. So, you know, we're pleased with the people that we have. It'll be a little bit of a work in progress as we learn how to work together and know exactly how everything fits together.
Stay back there with Cecil.
I have two real quick, Coach. First, you have the results of the Saban family Easter egg.
Yeah, Mommy and I blew them away.
You get them.
When I hide the eggs and look for them, it gives us a bit of an advantage. And Miss Terry has three different size eggs, and each one of them have certain value. So it's not only finding the eggs, it's finding the right ones so that you accumulate the points necessary to win. So Mommy was really happy about that.
And you talk about intangibles and leadership, and where is Damian Harris, who obviously could have chosen not to come back for his senior season, where is he?
Well, he's been great. I mean, I think the, you know, the players on offense have been, there's a lot of competition on offense, which I think lends itself to, you know, players going out there and competing. I think the experience and knowledge that some of these players have in terms of knowing what it takes to be able to be a successful, consistent performer. They do a good job of setting a good example, and certainly Damian has done that. He's been really good so far this spring. I've been pleased with that. Guys that, you know, make the decision he makes, they make one or two decisions. You know, they can't get over it. They can't get convicted and committed to, you know, trying to get better and doing the things to improve their status. They get a little complacent. He hasn't done that at all. He's worked hard. He worked hard in the off-season program, and he's had a really good spring. I think the competition in the offensive line and at receiver has, you know, sort of, you know, and at running back has brought out the best in a lot of guys. So that side of the ball I'm feel much better about right now in terms of the intangibles that we play with. And I think we got a work in progress on the other side to find some leadership and some people who have an alpha dog personality and are great competitors who hate to lose and are willing to go out there and do things that at the level, which is not easy to do, that they need to be able to do them so that we can have success on defense, especially with the inexperience that we have.
Come back over here with Charlie.
With Judy being injured and guys like Calvin, Cam, Rob, departing, how?
I can't hear you.
With Judy being injured and Cam and Calvin and Rob, all your receivers leaving, how beneficial are these reps in spring for a guy like Tyrell Shavers, and what have you seen from him?
Yeah, he's a talented guy, you know, and he's getting a lot of reps, you know, now especially. And you know, I think it's just a work in progress for him to learn the position because he hadn't played it before. But he's got some talent, and he's one of those guys that we need to develop and create a role for him because he certainly has the ability to contribute, and we certainly are going to work really hard to try to help him do that.
In the middle here with Michael.
Where have you seen progress with Najee Harris now in his second spring year?
I think Najee's got a little more confidence and knowledge of how to do things, what to do. Pass protection, doing things on a consistent basis. You know, he works really hard. He plays with great toughness. And I think he's got great intangibles as a player. I think that, you know, just the repetitions and the confidence that he has in knowing what he's supposed to do and how he's supposed to do it is probably the biggest thing that I see that's helped his consistency and performance.
Rob?
behind him with Christopher.
Just wondering, Craig Kiligowski, what was he like as a player for you, and was there something that you specifically wanted to bring to the defensive line when you hired him?
Look, I know defensive line is one of the areas that can set the tone on defense for how you control the front. Those guys are big guys. When they're physical and aggressive, I think it sets the tone for everybody on defense. I think that we need to make progress in that area. When Craig Kiligowski played, he played offense, and he was a very tough, physical guy, and we ran the ball a lot back in those days, and when we needed to, we'd run right behind him. So, and he was a good leader, and he has a good reputation as a coach, and he's done a good job with our players so far.
Two more. We'll start with Mark.
How have you seen Josh Castor sort of grow throughout his career, and what kind of role can he have on the offensive line this year?
Well, you know, we're mixing and matching a lot of different guys on the offensive line, but Josh is certainly in the mix, you know, at one of the guard positions. And, you know, he's very smart. He's a great leader. You know, he does everything the right way. He's got good explosion and good power. One thing that he works hard to overcome is his size, and I think he's proving to us every day that that's not an issue for him to be able to play. But I will say that there's probably seven or eight offensive linemen that are all in competition for positions, and he's one of those guys.
We'll finish up here with Alex.
I think I got two questions for you. First off, what have you seen from the nose guard position? It seems like there could be like a lack of experience and depth in there, so does that concern you at all?
I've been talking about my concerns on the defense, not just at nose guard, but in a lot of places. But I do think that we have played Quentin there some, and we think he can be a good player there. We have two young players that are freshmen that I think both can develop into being pretty good players there. And, you know, we signed a junior college nose guard the other day that will help us probably in the fall, too.
And lastly, I just kind of want to get your reaction the other day. Report that LeBron James sent a letter referring to the Shop Talk series. Did you have a reaction to it? What's your thought?
I don't have a reaction to it. I think LeBron James is a great player. There's been at least 20 barbershop-type things I've seen on TV. I didn't know anybody owned that. I didn't even know he had one. I'm sorry that anybody could be offended by something that we were just having fun with, and I enjoyed it, and we're going to continue to do it.
Thanks, Coach.